It could be recalled that on Sunday, 30th May 2021, the Ezi communities of Odoke, Obakota, Indigwin, Diobase, Inado local government area of Benue State became bloody over an attack by herdsmen numbering over 100, where more 116 Zin indigents lost their lives and property worth millions of naira destroyed. Speaking on behalf of the Ezi community, Idan Yagbo, Department Ruler of Ezi Community in Benue State, thanked Chief Philip Agbese, a House of Representative aspirant for Adeokpoku and Ogbaibodo Federal Constituency 2023, who paid a condolence visit to the area, while expressing displeasure over the abandonment of the community by Ado local government and Benue State government in their time of need.
Our plan about the Fulani people who come and kill our people. We are since looking whether the government will come and see us, but we don't see any one of the government. But now you come, we will tell you what is happening there. Anything you're supposed to do, you don't do it here, because the dead body where they kill, they don't bury them finish. Anything you do here, you don't do them there. By that, I say welcome. But we like make government give us road. Now road be the proper need for the place, yes, for community. Because if something happen without the road, people will kill everybody. If they say road day here, we for run go to hospital, as we know get hospital here. Now they kill very, very many people. We know get road to carry them to hospital. Only people who get people who have machine, only the people who survive. The people who no survive is the people who no get people to help them. That is the thing. We like you people who be government to help us to give us road and a hospital. Any place like Ado Bridge, it does spoil since it don't reach like 30-something years that Ado Bridge is spoiled. Since that time, we know they go Jigbang in the rain season. Up to now, nobody, if you people, and you take the road come, you see how the road break rich.
No light,
no borehole, no water, no hospital. Now hospital is the thing where that if you get hospital, that is life. Now we no get the hospital. If it's people fall sick, now women, old women, will carry small push hands, come give the person. If you are God, help, you survive. The people where they die in a month because of no hospital, we cannot, is uncountable.
Reacting to the ugly incident, Joseph Onwe, national president, is in Nodo Ambassadors Forum, lamented the abandonment and maltreatment of his people by government that should protect them. He recounted that the Ezi have lived in Benue for over 100 years, therefore shouldn't be treated as strangers in Benue, rather should be treated as indigenous.
More than 100 years ago, our problem started when the Igbos lost the Biafra War. They see us as enemy to other Nigerians. We are treated like fools, people who don't have bearing. They call us all sort of name, immigrant, impersonator. At the time, they were even more so, they were Idoma brothers who supposed to see us as one. They even come and mobilize themselves, come and pack our load, pack our things, beat us, say they are in control. But we thank God, the likes of people, that they thank God the world is globalizing. But we are the most painful aspect of this is that some leaders of Benue State who see us as strangers, we are not strangers here. Our forefathers, great-grandfather have been here before now. And they are still looking at us like we are still strangers. Since May 30th, where this thing happened, the local government chairman Ado have not visited the scene of this crisis. The governor Tommy, you see Tommy in television attacking Buhari here and there. He's hero in word and zero in action. He have not visited here. So we want the world to know our predicament. We are not part of this. Some of our women, if they go to that Ebony night, if they see Kruta, out of amazement, they even sit down on top, say they have seen what they have not seen. So we are begging the government, we are begging the spirited individuals to come to our aid. It's getting out of hand.
Responding, Philip Agbese, House of Representative aspirant for Adeokpoku and Ogbaibodo Federal Constituency, who was in Ezi on a condolence visit over the unfortunate attack and killings pleaded for peace and reminded the people of Ezi on the need for effective use of their vote in the coming election year.
I've been on the issue of security for some time across the country. We understand the true situation of things in the country and the problems of insecurity and the exact issues behind them. One of the issues around this community has to do with our peaceful coexistence and cohabitation with other members of the society. I think that is important. Learning to live at peace with your neighbor is the first thing that can guarantee your safety and peace. And empowering the youth and taking care of community in terms of fairness and justice and equity. And I strongly believe that this is one of the community that has not received that fairness or equity, you know, from the central government. It is unfortunate that we have a very highly placed citizen, people who are even in government, you know, from this community. They have not been able to do the much that they have been voted to do. So we believe that in the nearest future, we'll have that leadership that will be able to usher in that development. It's a question of willpower. And I think at the right time, people with the needed will to be able to do the right thing will come on board. So let's not sympathize too much with the community. It is time to move into action. And it calls for them to also take their destinies in their own hands. Because if they continue to make the mistake they have made in the past by electing the same set of people who have neglected them, they'll continue to remain neglected. So I believe that the nearest political window will offer them the needed opportunity, you know, for them to amend their own pattern of life. And I'm sure the moment that amendment is made, they'll begin to see amendment in the community.
The Ezi community are people from Ebonyi, from the Abuakuliki extraction, who are predominantly farmers. They migrated to Benue State in a quest for land for farming long before the Biafra War, and they have lived together with the host community of the Jagban and Ekele district of Ado local government area of Benue State for more than 100 years. They pay their tax, cast their votes, and participate in all social and economic activities in Benue State without recognition from the state. Ezi communities in Ado local government area of Benue State are in need of government and spirit-led individuals to heal their wounds.